The Inquisition cannot remain, Ambassador, if you can't prove it was founded on Justinia's orders.
This is an inopportune time, Marquis. More of the faithful flock here each day. But allow me to introduce you to the brave soul who risked her life to slow the magic of the breach. Sir Trevelyan, may I present the Marquis Durellion, one of Divine Justinia's greatest supporters.
And the rightful owner of Haven. House Durellion lent Justinia these lands for pilgrimage. This Inquisition is not a beneficiary of this arrangement.
This is the first I've heard of Haven having an owner outside the Chantry.
My wife, Lady Machin of Denner, has claim to Haven by ancient treaty with the monarchs of Ferelden. We were honored to lend its use to Divine Justinia. She was a woman of supreme merit. I will not let an upstart order remain on her holy grounds.
Interesting, considering the Inquisition was begun by the left and right hands of the Divine.
I've seen no written records from Sister Liliana or Seeker Pentacus that Justinia approved the Inquisition.
If he won't take her at her word, I'm afraid Seeker Pentacus must challenge him to a duel.
What?
It is a matter of honor among the Navarans. Shall I arrange the bout for tonight?
No. Perhaps my reaction to the Inquisition's presence was somewhat hasty.
We face a dark time, Your Grace. Divine Justinia would not want her passing to divide us. She would, in fact, trust us to forge new alliances to the benefit of all, no matter how strange they might seem.
I'll think on it, Lady Montillier. The Inquisition might stay in the meanwhile.
Do the Durellions actually have a claim on this place?
His Grace's position is not so strong as he presents it. Despite their Ferelden relations, the Durellions are Orlesian. If the Marquis wishes to claim Haven, Empress Selene must negotiate with the Ferelden on his behalf. Her current concerns are a bit larger than minor property disputes.
I'm so pleased the Marquis isn't tossing us out into the cold.
His Grace is only the first of many dignitaries we must contend with.
You expect more people in Haven?
Undoubtedly. And each visitor will spread the story of the Inquisition after they depart. An ambassador should ensure the tale is as complimentary as possible.
May I ask, what brought you to work for the Inquisition?
Sister Liliana approached me. We've been acquainted for quite some time. For better or worse, being the Inquisition's diplomat has become as interesting as she promised.
What sort of dealings have you had with nobility?
For some years, I was the royally appointed court ambassador from Antiva to Orlais. The nobility of Thedas is a rather singular sphere. Those I'm not acquainted with, I know through reputation.
The Inquisition is lucky to have you as an advocate, Lady Montillier.
Thank you. Let us hope so. Thedas' politics have become agitated as of late. I hope to guide us down smoother paths. But please excuse me. I've much work to do before the day is done. Good day to you.
How do you and Liliana know each other?
We moved through similar circles in Orlais. I believe we actually met in Val Royeaux. Liliana was quite an accomplished player of the game by then.
What exactly do you mean when you say the game?
Forgive me. The game refers to the slow duels of influence among the noble and powerful of Orlais. It's a rather light-hearted name for the matter, but Orlesians are fond of playful touches.
Tell me, do you believe I was saved by Andraste at the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
I should much like to believe so, Your Worship. The miracles Andraste performed were so long ago, they're difficult to picture. If it were truly her and the fate who saved you... Well, in any case, many already believe you walk in the Maker's light.
What business are the Montpelier's in exactly?
We began as merchants. My ancestors founded the first trade routes to Rivain. We once sent entire fleets across the Waking Sea.
But not anymore.
Ah, no. These days, our vessels are a touch more modest.
What did you do before coming here?
I had the great honor of serving Antiva's crown as ambassador to Orlais. I'm also first in line to become the head of House Montpelier, though my siblings attend to our mercantile affairs.
How strong are your past loyalties?
I would never have given up my position if I did not intend to fully commit to the Inquisition. We cannot fall back on borders. Antiva is as threatened as any country by the rebellions. If anything, the alliances I forged there may help our current cause.
Do you think the Inquisition will continue after we seal the breach?
If we prove ourselves by healing the breach, people may turn to us for other things. Protection, counsel, justice. The Inquisition offered these once to those in need.
I'd swear our families have met before.
Perhaps. Everyone of distinction in the Free Marches attends Lady Trevelyan's summer balls.
Great Aunt Lucille always did love a party.
I don't recall seeing you at any of them.
Attend one ball, and you'll fend off invites for a dozen more.
That reminds me. The Herald of Andraste has received several invitations from the Curious.
To parties? How many am I getting?
Only 17 this month, I'm afraid.
Let's speak later.
Farewell. Good day to you.
What exactly does your job entail?
I meet with ambassadors from various factions and countries, and cement alliances with them. We are a young cause. Diplomacy is essential to our credibility.
Then you speak for the Inquisition with these nobles?
I do. Someone must foster goodwill on our behalf, as well as prevent controversy as news of us spreads.
How heavily are our actions scrutinized?
Make no mistake. Every noble house, every throne, is waiting to see what the Inquisition does next. Many are willing to pledge support, if offers are made in just the right fashion. I intend to see that they are.
Tell me how you came to work for the Inquisition again.
I'd been considering leaving my post in Antiva for a new challenge when Leliana recruited me. There's such unrest in Thedas, and the Inquisition seems a promising method to stop it. It's to everyone's benefit if we prevent the Mage-Templar conflict from spreading further.
So was it the prospect of stability that drew you here?
The full impact of the Mage Rebellion has yet to be felt, and that was before the death of the Divine. The violence must be curbed before we see it turn to full-scale war.
The Inquisition's primary goal is still closing the rift in the Fade.
Which likely means finding the Divine's murderer. That will make the Inquisition a rallying point, regardless of what tack we take. I fear these conflicts will not leave us untouched.
What do the people make of us?
Despite our fame, we're low on steadfast allies. We must aim for more.
Any visiting dignitaries I should watch out for?
Sir Griffith of Denerim, a most distinguished knight of the realm. He's defeated darkspawn, slain demons, chased down abominations. Just don't ask him about it over dinner. He spares no detail. I'd like to discuss your parents.
A little sudden, but it's time someone made an honest woman of me.
What? Very amusing. This is serious. I'd like to dispatch a courier asking the bands of House Trevelyan to align themselves with us. What are your thoughts? Should we approach your family for their formal support of the Inquisition?
My parents are on a first-name basis with most priests in Ostwick, and I have a dozen cousins in the Chantry. When they hear I've been touched by Andraste, you'll have to stop them from giving you money.
I'll take that as a yes. Valroyo has noted your lineage. It gives the Inquisition some legitimacy, although not so much as we'd hoped.
Why not?
You are from Ostwick. Orlesian nobles consider the Three Marches somewhat quaint.
Orlesians are just baffled Free Marches governing themselves without an Empress to hold their hands.
A peasant might get away with that insult, but not someone of your stature. Speaking of which, I should thank you for your patience with the simple quarters. The accommodations in Haven are surely rough for someone of your birth.
This can't be what you're accustomed to, Ambassador.
One adjusts. I stay busy. It helps take my mind from our surroundings. And the cold. And the wildlife. And the lack of civilization for miles around. Why anyone lived here before we found Andraste's ashes, I cannot imagine.
Having a few leagues of ice between me and whoever wishes me ill can't hurt.
Do not say that too loudly. Chancellor Roderick is still here. Until next time, my lady.
I'll take my leave. Good day.
Who is she, Ambassador?
A merchant. I thought we should reach out to the dwarves to secure Illyrium for the Inquisition's Templars. According to Lady Corpin, it raised the ire of the Chantry.
How?
Access to Illyrium makes us rather more formidable than I anticipated. We're becoming a challenge. Sadly, the remaining Grand Clerics appear to be consolidating the Chantry's power, instead of comforting the masses.
The Chantry should be a place of hope, not another group scrambling for answers.
That must be its strength again. The Chants did much to bridge nations. Little but the Chantry ties Orlais, Nivara, Ferelden, Antiva, and even Rivain to a common cause.
Has the Chantry truly promoted such peace?
Andraste's chant is familiar across kingdoms, a source of many shared customs. That is the crucial point. Common ground is the start of all negotiations.
So if everyone listens to the chant, things will be smooth as silk.
I did say commonality is merely a beginning, but it's an important one. We must learn to think beyond our own wants to secure peace in Thedas.
How did someone so lovely and selfless go into Orlesian politics, Lady Montellier?
Well, that is, really, you give me too much credit. While you're here, I do have a question. The remaining Grand Clerics sent a missive inquiring about the events at the Temple of Sacred Ashes. They demand to know whether the Inquisition officially claims that Andraste saved you from the breach. If it were up to you, how would you reply?
Will my answer change your reply to the Chantry?
If Leliana, Cassandra, Cullen, and I could agree on our official stance, I could answer that. We should decide soon. The revered mothers don't seem to know what to make of you.
I'd tell the Chantry that Andraste herself shielded me from harm.
I'd truly like to hear the debates that would raise in Val Royeaux. Thank you for your thoughts. A good day to you. Inquisitor, I was just inspecting our new headquarters. Foundation cracks, nesting animals, and miles from any centers of civilization. The staff must make it presentable if we're to receive any visitors of distinction.
It certainly wouldn't do for the Inquisition to appear overly shabby.
We've only just now convinced everyone we are precisely what Thedas requires. The Templars came far to fight with us. They need to feel secure here.
Do you not feel safe here?
I've had difficulty forgetting Corypheus's attack on Haven. Do you know who first leapt to arms? Our workers. They were so proud of our cause. Corypheus simply cut them down. So much screaming after that first blast of fire. So many people turned to ash.
We lost far too many good people to that monster.
I'm sure they'll find rest with the Maker. Well, before I return to my duties, allow me to congratulate you on your appointment as Inquisitor, my lady. I will now bring diplomatic issues to your attention. and I'm more than happy to help with any situations that arise.
I'm loath to part from such pleasant company. Would you care to walk the castle with me?
Oh, well, a tour then? Let me fetch the steward.
That isn't precisely what I was hoping for.
Well, do let me know if you change your mind. Now I must find someone to prepare the guest quarters. Inquisitor, is it true? Is the mark on your hand magic cast by Corypheus?
Corypheus claimed it's a spell gone wrong.
I wanted to think it was a blessing. A sign the Maker was returning to his creation. How credulous of me.
I thought the same thing about the anchor, Josephine.
I suppose neither of us could have known what your mark was until now. Does it hurt? The anchor, that is.
It looks strange, but it hasn't done me harm.
If it did come from Corypheus, that's a small mercy. And what else did Lady Forsythia say?
That she'd rather drown herself than help the Inquisition.
Anything else?
She said she'd have us flogged alive if we allied with her brother.
That does sound like her.
Cheer up, Josie. We at least have her attention.
You always do find the brighter side of things. We are in the midst of cementing an alliance with Lady Forsythia of Nevara, Your Worship. It's become a somewhat delicate task.
Can I do anything to help negotiations?
Thank you, but I believe I have matters in hand. I dissuaded her from sending soldiers when she learned we'd struck an accord with a brother she's feuding with. Lady Forsythia simply employs a colorful manner of speech.
You're rather good-natured about threats of death and dismemberment.
They are chiefly bluster, Inquisitor. Most of them. But I confess, I do miss my staff from the embassy in Antiva. It was always useful to discuss the day's visitors with them.
I have time if you'd like to review things with me.
I wouldn't wish to impose.
If it were imposing, I wouldn't have offered.
Well, I admit, there are a few potential alliances it would be good to discuss. Right on the parlor floor. In front of everyone at the soiree. Who does such a thing in front of their guests?
The Duke of Kellington, apparently.
And then there's Cole's lurking. It frightens our guests half to death. Lord Jynarr still won't respond to our letters. And Sarah, can she not find a single overshirt with that mustard taint on it? Then there's Dorian. The man refuses to take anything seriously unless it suits its whim. Not to mention... Oh, oh goodness. Have we been here an hour already?
It went by so quickly, I didn't even notice.
You're far too polite. I didn't intend to go on for so long. You must think me quite the gossip.
Spending time with such an engaging woman is never unpleasant, Lady Montpellier.
Goodness! I'm glad I haven't wasted your day. Well, I've taken up quite enough of your time already. Until next time, Your Worship. Yes.
Who rules Antiva?
Officially, the Principality of Antiva is governed by His Majesty King Fugelno II. In reality, Antiva's merchant princes rule the country in everything but name. Quite loudly, I might add.
What sort of dealings did you have with these merchant families?
As ambassador, I attended Privy Council meetings in a mediatory capacity. May I just say, one has never heard an argument until they've sat in on 15 princes howling down each other's tariff suggestions.
That sounds more like a mob than a meeting.
It's all a part of life in Antiva. Our traditions value passion and romance. A certain exuberance of style.
Are you positive you're Antivan?
I can be most exuberant when it's called for. Just at the right moment, and in a proper fashion. Might we speak of something else?
What's the land like in Antiva?
The settled areas are quite lush. The vineyards run as far as the eye can see in some places. Antiva City, however, perches right up against the Rialto Bay. That's what I miss most. The sea crashing against the maze of the docks.
I have difficulty seeing you wandering around a trading port.
Everyone in Antiva City spends time by the ships, my lady. The finest restaurants and poets all make their habitation by the sea. The waterfront's never still. Lanterns are lit along the promenade, no matter what the weather.
Are you ever homesick?
Occasionally. When a breeze stirs the trees in the garden, I sometimes pretend it's the sound of the surf. Do you know, I even miss those terrible squawking birds infesting the harbor. My youngest sister used to throw whole loaves of bread to the gulls. Silly thing.
You said the Montpelliers used to run an entire trading fleet. What happened?
There was a scandal in Val Royale more than an age ago. The Montpelliers were forbidden from trading with Orlais. Our personal fortunes never quite rebounded.
Does anyone in Orlais even remember what that scandal was?
I doubt it, but the injunction persists.
What exactly happened?
An affair with a minor lord. Perhaps. Most other details are lost.
Are you saying your family's livelihood was ruined because of a love affair no one even remembers?
Essentially. Orlesian politics are full of these unhappy little missteps, Inquisitor.
You haven't really gone into detail about how you know Leliana.
We met... let me think. We met the last few years of my schooling, but we became friends after I became ambassador to Orlais. It seems terrifyingly long ago now.
How exactly did you and Leliana reconnect in the Inquisition?
I discovered my family had been overcharging a merchant we traded with for months. Our name carries a great deal of trust in Antiva. I spent weeks arranging a string of favors as suitable recompense. Apparently satisfied, the merchant extended me an invitation to her estate. Leliana greeted me in place of the merchant.
I assume there was more to it than a strange way to say hello.
It was a test of sorts. Leliana claimed she needed someone of painful integrity for the Inquisition. I accepted, once she finally explained what it was.
Do you remain close?
Yes, but she's grown so much more distant than the outgoing woman I met in Val Royale. Leliana used to wander the Orlesian courts, singing the sweetest songs, charming the greatest wits. Now she collects secrets and takes risks that would make empires tremble. I worry, but she will not hear it.
Does Leliana confide in you?
If she enjoys revisiting our more disastrous adventures, Leliana used to concoct the most ridiculous plans. Run if you ever see her with a twine ball, a measuring stick, and a handkerchief.
Tell me about the Montpelliers.
Well, my parents are alive and in good health. They live in our estate in Antiva City. Of my four siblings, most attend to the running of the family vineyards. That reminds me, I must ask someone to make sure Yvette attends the spring reception at the palace. My youngest sister has no head for social engagements.
Why are you overseeing your siblings' social lives?
It's Antivan custom. After a certain age, the heir apparent runs the family's estate to prove they're worthy of succession. If you're unfit for the task, the heads of the house, usually one's parents, may decree a new heir.
What do these Antivan heads of the households do, if they don't run it?
They work and provide guidance. I've taken advice from my parents. Well, mostly mother. Father's more of an artist. It's rather gauche, but we never can dissuade him from running his own salons. Between him and my siblings, mother's looking forward to my taking over the estate.
Between that and the Inquisition, when do you ever rest?
Delegation helps a great deal. But managing the estate is my duty. As much work as it is, I will not shirk it.
Is running your family's estate that important to you?
I'm responsible for their welfare. A Montelier never shuns their familial duty. Taxing, as those duties can sometimes be.
Maybe your siblings could help lighten your burden.
You don't know them. But Lorien in charge, or Antoine, or Yvette? No, truly. It must be me.
Where were you raised, Josephine?
I was born in Antiva City, but when I turned 15, Mother declared I'd attend finishing school in Val Royeaux. But I bowled into her skirts the day I had to leave.
You must have missed her terribly.
I did. And she was most unsympathetic to my wailing. But my mother only wanted the best for me. Living in Orlais was an education in itself.
What did you learn at this finishing school in Val Royeaux?
Among other things, mathematics, rhetoric, poetry, history, logic, and a great deal of etiquette. I still remember Madame Beventir's switch on my knuckles when I forgot the basic tenets of Navarran dining customs. For a dowager approaching her 80th year, she had quite the arm.
How did the younger you like Val Royeaux when you arrived?
Have you ever stepped into a new city and felt the buildings couldn't possibly be real? That was Val Royeaux to me. So beautifully foreign, I gaped at its spires for months.
Does Antiva City have nothing that compares to Val Royeaux?
Antiva City is a jewel among the capitals. But I did not appreciate that before I traveled. There are multitudes of places I'd like to see. Seheron, the Anderfels, whatever lies past the Amaranthine Ocean. Inquisitor, I must speak with you.
What is it?
I must explain something first about the Montelier's fortunes.
I remember you said your family had been forbidden from trading in Orlais.
It devastated our finances. The Montelier's have, in fact, been in debt for over 100 years.
I had no idea your family's situation was so precarious.
Hardly anyone outside the family does. For generations, we've done everything to keep creditors at bay. Sold our lands to stave off interest. It's just... it is infuriating to see my family still reduced to this. I'm to become head of our house. If I sell any more of our land, my family will become destitute. That cannot be my legacy to them.
Most people worry about their next meal, never mind an estate.
I'm not blind, but I worry for my family. My foolish sister Yvette with her daydreams, my brothers trying to rebuild our fleet with their own hands. Is it wrong to hope they never know hardship?
Is there anything I can do?
I'd almost solved our problems. For a while. I negotiated a chance to reinstate the Montelier's as landed traders in Orlais. We could rebuild with that. But when I dispatched paperwork to Val Royeaux... I've just learned my carriers were murdered, and the documents restoring my family's trading status destroyed.
Do you have any idea who murdered them?
Leliana made inquiries that bore success. Comte Boisvert, a nobleman in Val Royeaux, claims to know who killed my messengers. He has a request that you come when I meet him, so he's seen publicly conferring with you.
What will being seen with me gain the Comte?
The Comte will drop hints at parties he's to meet with an important visitor. Allies and rivals will take note. Once he's met you, there will be speculation. The Comte will subtly spin reports to his advantage. He will use us. But if he knows who killed my people, I ask that we indulge him.
If that's what it takes to get to the bottom of this, I'll meet this Comte with you.
Thank you, Inquisitor. It means... you are too kind. I must know who killed my couriers just to harm my family.
Welcome, my friend.
Thank you for seeing us, Comte Bauer.
The honor is mine. Please, sit. It's an honor to assist two such distinguished guests.
We appreciate your help, Comte.
The death of Lady Montilly's servants must weigh heavily on you. Have you heard of the House of Repose?
The Assassins' League?
My contacts obtained a copy of a document in the archive. Contract for life.
The House of Repose is hereby sworn to eliminate anyone attempting to overturn the Montilliers' trading exile in Orlais.
Overly complicated assassination plots are part of Orlesian politics, I take it.
They're all too common, I'm afraid.
The contract was signed by a noble family. The Du Parquets.
But the Du Parquets died out as a noble line over 60 years ago.
Indeed. But the contract was signed 109 years ago.
How can a family try to kill you after they died out?
The Du Parquets were our rivals. They drove the Montilliers from Val Royal. This contract was drawn up over 100 years ago, but it wasn't invoked until I tried to overturn my family's exile.
Unpleasant though it may be, the House of Repose is merely fulfilling its contractual duties.
If the people who wanted your family dead are gone, why are the assassins still after you?
A contract is a contract, Inquisitor. Orlesian businesses live and die by their reputations. The entire guild's welfare would be endangered if an agreement was tossed aside on a whim of time or fate.
She's quite right, Your Worship. The House of Repose is doing what it feels necessary, by its standards.
I assume you have a thought or two on this, Josephine?
The Du Parquets still have descendants under the common branch. If we elevate them to nobility, a Du Parquet could annul the contract on my life.
That will take time, Lady Montilier. Time during which the House of Repose will be obliged to haunt you.
Will they now? You are exceedingly well informed, but not to have said you'd heard rumors at best.
A bit of subterfuge. This contract on your life is an ugly business. One the House of Repose deeply regrets. But this is Orlais. Even an assassin's word is his bond.
Does Comte Boisvert actually exist?
Absolutely. The Comte's offer to reveal the killers of Lady Montilly's messengers was genuine. So was his information somehow. An end to be tied up later.
I thought you were remarkably well informed about a secret assassin's guild.
We are hardly secret, my dear Inquisitor, just normally much more reclusive. The contract on Lady Montilly's life is so unusual, we felt the courtesy of an explanation was in order.
It is appreciated, Monsieur.
Your idea to seek out the Du Parquet to revoke our orders is an interesting one. I wish you luck. I did not come to shed blood today, Inquisitor. Only to speak. Might I pass?
Why warn us about your contract and let us go?
In Orlais, it is only decent to inform those involved in a contract when extraordinary circumstances conspire.
And the guild's reputation would suffer if you ignored the contract. I quite understand.
Thank you, my lady. May we conclude with my departure?
Not on your life.
As you wish.
Our meeting would end like this.
We'll deal with these assassins.
I have some thoughts. Let's discuss them back at Skyhorn. I'll feel safer with the castle walls around me.
Do you hear something?
Oh, goodness. Comte Poivre, is that you? Oh, the lock's been broken off. We'll find a saw.
I realize the cabinet is quite valuable, Comte, but surely... A... locksmith, then? As you wish. I'm so sorry, Inquisitor. I never thought my family's trading status would trap us in an assassin's plot.
You couldn't have known it would lead to this House of Repose coming after you.
It still shouldn't have slipped past me. I've tracked down the last du Paraquets. If they become gentry, they can annul the contract on my life. We'll require a noble from Val Royeaux to sponsor them, a judge to provide documents, a minister to ratify them.
It's so like you to take the longest course of action, even when your life is at stake.
I assume you already know everything about this mess.
There is a faster way, Josephine. The original contract on your life is in the vaults of the House of Repose. If my agents infiltrate it and destroy the original, the assassin will have no obligation to chase you.
Leliana, please. I want no more bloodshed over a personal affair.
Don't be so stubborn, Josie. How long will it take you to gather these favors in Val Royeaux?
We can solve this without more deaths on either side.
My people are ready, should you change your mind. I'll post a watch on our ambassador in case the House of Repose visits.
I appreciate it, but I still believe elevating the du Paraquets will solve this. First, we need to perform some favors in Val Royeaux. I'd be happy to discuss where we could begin. Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
You said I'd have to do some favors in Val Royeaux if we want to make the du Paraquets lords.
The Countess Dion is our first step. Her lover, a mage from the White Spire, is missing. Bring her news of him, and she'll be very amenable to sponsoring the du Paraquets as lords. Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
How exactly does one turn farmers into members of the upper classes?
There are procedures for granting honored citizens of the Empire the title of lord or lady. Very long procedures. And so much paperwork. I've called in a substantial number of favors just to cut through half of it.
Why did the du Paraquets hate the Montilliers so much they set up a permanent assassination watch?
There's not much more beyond what I mentioned before. A Montillier and a du Paraquet fell in love. A young couple, pledged elsewhere, attempted to elope. The whole thing ended so violently, it's a wonder any survived. It's fortunate the du Paraquet's descendants hold no grudges.
What if the du Paraquets refused to aid you?
I've already contacted the du Paraquets, Inquisitor. They're ready to help us. It will be a long road, but a lordship is a chance to restore a proud lineage to their heirs. Besides, I've promised them a heavy bag of coin once this is over.
Are you sure the House of Repose will forget this assassin contract on a farmer's signature?
It's perfectly legal. In Val Royeaux's noble circles, a written word is a bond. Besides, the guild would never risk being so unspeakably crass.
These assassins are afraid of being seen as impolite.
Breaking one's public oath or bond implies a certain... poverty in Orlais. A common merchant may lack the resources or manners to fulfill a debt, but among the guilds, it would be shameful.
Let's speak later.
Farewell. Inquisitor!
What happened here?
The House of Repose decided to pay a visit. The guards arrived in time, but I should have guessed the assassins would infiltrate the servants.
Are you sure they didn't hurt you?
They only frightened me. It was all so sudden. Leliana assigned people to shadow me. They appear to have saved my life. I owe you everything, Sergeant.
Only my duty, Ambassador. I'll talk with the Spymaster about these murderous louts. She'll find how they got in.
Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
What's the next favor we need to get these du Paraquets a lordship?
We need a judge of the Royal Court to procure documents acknowledging them as nobility again. I received a letter from the House of Repose, Your Worship. They acknowledge their contract is null and void. There is no longer a price on my life. They... also send their compliments on how handily you dispatched their agent pretending to be the Comte.
I'm glad you don't have to live your life looking over your shoulder anymore.
I regret we were forced to deal with them. That you were endangered by my part in the game. Did I ever mention I used to be a bard?
You were a singer?
Bards entertain the Orlesian court. They sing, play music, make charming conversation, and spy. Many young nobles put on a mask and practice playing the game in such a fashion.
What made you interested in becoming a bard?
I was attending a university in Val-Royal when I learned about bards. There was such an air of romance about them. Stories of secrets, trysts, and fascinating people. A group of us, young gentry from Antiva, decided this exciting life was for us.
I don't imagine many firstborn heirs join those ranks.
No. I was a rather foolish exception. During one particular intrigue, I encountered a bard sent to kill my patron. We fought. Or perhaps scrapped is the better word. Both of us terrified. We were at the top of a steep flight of stairs. The other bard drew a knife, and I pushed him away from me. You can imagine the result.
You were only defending yourself.
But it was such a waste, Inquisitor. When I took off his mask, I knew him. We'd attended parties together. If I'd stopped to reason, if I'd used my voice instead of scuffling like a common thug, I'll always wonder who that young man would have grown into.
He seemed willing enough to murder you for the game.
Perhaps. I feel I'm the last to judge whether or not he would have actually used the blade. In all the commotion, forgive me. I don't believe I ever thanked you for helping me with this.
I'd do it again in a heartbeat. Such a gracious woman deserves nothing less.
Such talk. I'm quite overcome.
Should I stop?
Oh, no. I mean, yes. I meant, no, I don't... Well, if you meant to draw a blush to my cheeks, you've completely succeeded. Let's return to Skyhold before anyone notices. Rather urgent. A pleasure.
How do you stay so civil with everyone, Josephine?
Bonds of circumstance among the nobility are fickle. Civility is the only constant everyone admires. And I do deplore rudeness in those who know better.
Does it even become a strain sometimes?
Well, it can be trying. There is no shortage of self-regard among the nobility. The game can be wearying, discouraging, and extremely baneful. But honestly, I'd miss meeting people. I've made the most fascinating friends.
One good thing about becoming Inquisitor has been meeting so many different people.
I'm pleased. I imagine we appear a strange bunch to those outside our circle. Mages, Templars, Seekers, and an apostate elf are not often found working in harmony. Or at all.
Let's speak later.
Farewell.
Inquisitor, may I have a word? I notice you've made Lady Montelier quite a number of compliments.
Yes. I enjoy her company very much.
An entanglement with our ambassador seems most unwise. I asked Josephine to join the Inquisition because we needed a diplomat. Not so she could be toyed with.
I enjoy being with Josephine. I'm not trying to break her heart.
Then I would be more cautious. Josephine's no stranger to courtly intrigue. But love? There she's an innocent. She has no idea you are truly attracted to her. If indeed you are.
Yes, I'm very attracted to Josephine.
Is that so? Whatever is between you, I ask that you treat her with kindness. For her sake, as well as yours.
Whatever happens, I'm glad to see Josephine has a concerned friend here.
I have so few true friends these days. Those that are left, I deeply cherish. I will not trouble you any further, but I do watch over my friends. Good day, Your Worship.
Well, Leliana just gave me quite the speech.
What about?
About us?
Oh, she is impossible.
Might we discuss this somewhere more private?
Leliana said I was an innocent in love?
More or less.
Of all the... I'm quite capable of understanding our association. I've never thought your intentions were overly romantic, Inquisitor, I assure you.
Perhaps I should have composed a ballad, then. Or sent roses.
What? You mean you do? We've only just... I didn't wish to presume you harbored any tender feelings for me.
I have no objections. Presume away.
But we haven't even known each other a few short months. How can you declare this liking for me after such a brief time together?
I've never met anyone whose presence affects me like you do. Perhaps it just means I'm a hopeless romantic, but there you have it.
I would not object to a closer relationship between us, my lady. If that sounds agreeable to you.
I'm actually quite glad Leliana prompted this talk.
I suppose she was right after all. Please don't tell her I said that.
I wouldn't dream of it.
How are you, my lady?
I'm courting the most beautiful woman in the entire castle. That helps a great deal.
Oh my, you flatter me much too much.
How far do your roots go back to Orlais?
Very far. The Montilliers used to have vast holdings in Val-Royaux itself. I wish I could have seen them, especially the ones bearing the family crest. The original crest design was abandoned when we were exiled from the city. I've always wanted to find a copy.
Has our being together set any tongues wagging?
Undoubtedly. A rumor already gave you a dozen suitors the moment you took your title.
Who were these rumors pairing me with?
I can only speak to what was whispered in several courts.
Josephine.
To begin with, Cassandra, Leliana, Cullen, Dorian, Mother Giselle, the Lord Seeker, Chancellor Roderick, two barons, three maids, and some man named Philip. Honestly, I don't think he even exists.
Why was Leliana so set against us being together, Josephine?
Think nothing of it. She'd disapprove of anyone I chose to keep serious company with. Back in Val-Royaux, Leliana was practically my older sister.
So you two never had a romantic history together?
A romantic? You did hear me say Leliana was like a sister to me. She's a most dear friend, and nothing more.
I thought we might go somewhere a little more private for a while.
I have so much to do, but... Oh, let's do. After you. What's this?
You said you wanted to see your original family crest. I found one for you.
I'm astonished. I'd given up hope that any example of the early family crest still existed. It even has our first motto, back from when we had a trading fleet to speak of. From sea to shore, we tame the waves.
Anything to see you smile.
You've certainly succeeded. Thank you. There you are. I've been looking all over for you. I've just received the most terrible news.
What is it?
I'm engaged.
I sense this is complicated. Tell me more.
For the past year, my mother and father have searched Antiva for a match for me. They had no idea you and I had grown so close. Today, I received a letter declaring they've betrothed me to Lord Adorno Cielo Tranto of Antiva. I must deal with this. But until then, we cannot be seen in a compromising situation. I'm so sorry.
Are you saying we should act like nothing's happened between us?
No. No, not at all. But it is not right that we carry on while I am betrothed. I must break off the match first.
Let me know what I can do, Josephine.
No. Thank you so much, but no. Until I know more, I cannot risk a reputation. Why did this have to happen to us now, of all times? I must see to this. And to my other duties. If I can keep my mind on them today at all.
If I dueled this Lord Otranto, I could force him to give up his betrothal with you.
But you could be hurt. Dueling is a very precise sport. Men and women spend years perfecting their skills with a rapier. I couldn't bear to think of my family putting you in any further danger. Again.
Tell me again about this Antivan lord your parents engaged you to.
Adorno Cielo Tranto? His family runs several shipping companies in Antiva that do very well. Of the man's temper and disposition and habits, I know nothing. Well, Mother claims he enjoys sailing and dueling, but what Antivan lord doesn't?
You don't favor this marriage, Josephine, do you?
Certainly not. If I hadn't met you, perhaps I'd have been amenable, but honestly, you've no worry.
Does Antiva law force you to marry? Can't you break off the betrothal?
In theory, I very easily could. In reality, if I reject Lord Otranto without proper niceties, it will scar my family's name. Perhaps ignite a feud. Disentangling myself from the engagement will take months. Or years.
While you're worried about your family, what happens to us?
I cannot be with you until the question of this engagement is settled. It is simply not my own reputation. It is my family's. I do not have the right to risk it. As much as I might wish to. Why did this become so dreadfully complicated?
Let's speak later.
Another time.
I am Lord Otranto of Antiva, rightfully betrothed of Lady Josephine Montelier. Songs of your exploits have spread to my city, Inquisitor. It's humbling to make your acquaintance. It is a pity it will not last longer. Before we duel, I trust you find the weapon to your satisfaction.
Am I not allowed to pick my means of defense?
I am the wounded party in this duel. Tradition dictates that I select our weapons. Of course, if you fear you might be clumsy with such a refined instrument, there is no shame in a forfeit.
Rapiers will do, if you're out of your depth with a more substantial weapon.
Very good. Let us begin. An admirable start, Inquisitor.
Perhaps House Trevelyan isn't the obscure backwater I've heard it to be. I'm glad Lady Montilier isn't here, exquisite as I've heard her appearance to be. Cutting you down in front of Josephine would have given a poor first impression of House Otranto to my bride.
Strange. I would think the Otrantos already have enough blood on their hands after cheating the Terrazzas.
Who told you? You dared to bring up that slander here? Inquisitor, I will personally...
Stop! Josephine!
Lady Montilier, what a pleasure to...
What are you doing?
Lord Otranto and I are settling our differences about your betrothal.
That's not your decision. The Inquisition needs you. I need you. Yet you threw yourself into danger. Why do this? Why risk everything we've built? Why risk your life?
Because I love you.
You do?
She does?
Yes, Josephine. I love you so much.
I love you too.
Well fought.
Lord Otranto.
I'd assumed your liaison with the Inquisitor was an affair of passion or convenience, Lady Montilier. But I'm not fool enough to stand in the way of true affection. The Otrantos regretfully withdraw the terms of our betrothal.
Thank you.
Do not thank me. I know when I'm outmatched.
I can't imagine a better ending, but wouldn't you be impressed by a dueling scar?
My dearest lady, I love you precisely the way you are. Just do kiss me again. I can't stop thinking about your duel in Val Royeau. Running into the middle of the crowd, the noise, the swords flashing. I was so worried for you, but at the same time, well, it was the most exciting thing I've seen in ages.
You do remember what this Inquisition has been doing, don't you?
Allow me to correct myself. The most exciting thing I have seen that didn't threaten to stop my heart. You know, when I first laid eyes on you back at Haven, I hadn't an inkling we'd become so close.
At least tell me your breath was stolen away by my incredible beauty.
You are too much. These moments seem so dear, especially given your greater calling. Sometimes I must remind myself that I'm required to share you with the rest of the world.
The world may want my time, Josephine, but you have my heart.
Then I count myself happy, beyond compare.
Oh, Josephine, is this her?
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montilier.
Delighted to meet you, Lady Montilier.
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true? You and Josephine are going to elope and move to the Anderfels and join the Grey Wardens and fight Darkspawn?
Yvette!
I want to know.
I already packed our bags, didn't I, darling?
I knew it!
Inquisitor, please give her no more ammunition. I beg you.
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette.
Stop. Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Huh. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette! That's... absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
Which power should the Inquisition throw its weight behind?
Selene has held the throne successfully for years. I see no profit in ousting her. Gaspard has run military campaigns, but never a kingdom. His transition would be, let us say, chaotic.
Tell me about yourself, Lady Yvette. This is the first time I've encountered any of Josephine's family.
She would forget to mention the artists. I've been studying painting under Antiva's royal tutors. You should be proud, Josie. I'm going to be exhibiting my work next season in the city's biggest salon.
Have you actually sat down and finished the painting yet?
I must wait for my inspiration.
And I must wait for your tutor's bills.
Enjoying the ball?
I see many of them.
The dancing is so dull, your worship. But the Empress's gallery is magnificent.
Yvette.
Sorry, Josie.
Go on, Josephine.
Half our royal must be empty. So many of the Empire's finest are in attendance. They've noticed the Empress paying you special attention, but they don't quite know how to take advantage of it yet. This uncertainty won't last long, I'm afraid.
I'll see you later.
Another time.
Is everything all right? You look troubled.
This isn't over yet. Corypheus will strike back at us for this loss.
He surely will. But we'll be ready for whatever comes. Is there anything I can do? Can I get you anything? A drink, perhaps?
Would you care to dance with me, Lady Josephine?
I would love to, my lady. I hear this Illuvian lies in a temple nearby. No doubt you're departing for it now. Be safe.
Once we're home, we'll spend quite some time in private.
How can you think of that now?
How can I not?
We'll arrange something now. Return once you can. We must plan for you to fight one last duel, my darling. This time for all of us. Once you find Corypheus, I suppose we must wait.
I'll be thinking of you every step past Skyhold.
Flattering, but you have my permission to think of your battle. Please be sure to. I hope that you'll...
Maker, I wish you didn't have to go.
You mean the world to me, Josephine Montpellier.
Then return to me safely. I must attend to some tasks before you draw out our enemy. Do go before I begin to cry.
new caterer so late.
Leave it be, Josie. Everything's fine.
It is not!
I'm so sorry. Nothing is quite as it should be. Do you like the drinks? I'm not sure about them.
If I told you the port was a little dry, would you burst into flame?
You're joking, yes? Please tell me you're joking. What a disaster. So many was late, the invitation to our guests barely went out at all, and it was so wonderful to prepare for a small banquet instead of the end of the world. Do you know what everyone is talking about tonight, from commoners to kings?
Us. Thedas is discussing the successor of the Inquisition.
You played no small part in our rise to power.
You had a role yourself, if I recall correctly.
Truly, we will never forget those we lost. But for tonight, to victory.
May I join you?
I wanted to catch you. The celebrations appear to be winding down with the sunrise. I've never witnessed such a lovely sight.
I am standing right here, you know.
Shall I compare you to the sun?
Go on, write a few couplets.
I could not do you justice. It's been good to have the celebration free of what the future holds. Whatever awaits us, my lady, I know only one thing. I would never have you face it alone.
It's so good to see you, darling. I've been fielding Orlesian diplomats all afternoon.
Have they given you trouble?
Not at all. It is quite alarming. It means they are all saving themselves up for later. Would you walk with me? I should like to take some air before the Exalted Council becomes inescapable. The palace has been most accommodating. We are, after all, here at their insistence, but the ministers may... No. No more talk of the Council. This meeting was to spend time with you in a more relaxed fashion.
Then why can I still see those wheels turning in your head?
Work carries a certain momentum. The truth is, there is a small entertainment happening tonight, to which I may be able to find a pair of invitations.
You'd like me to go with you?
Very much so. In all the years you've worked with Orlais, you had so little time to enjoy its culture.
I do wish you'd warned me the game would take more work after Halam Shiral.
It's strange. Those were somehow simpler times. Sometimes, I'm afraid I do not make enough time for you, my love. Please, come with me tonight.
And what is this small entertainment?
Something to ease our minds. I would very much like to surprise you with the details.
If it makes you happy, how can I refuse?
Oh, wonderful. I was worried we wouldn't find the time. The past years have been so busy. We have earned at least a few moments of rest.
A calm night out sounds...
Oh, bravo! Bravo!
I've been in battles that were quieter than this.
Oh, yes. What a stupendous voice Lady Brask has. Her D-sharp once shattered an entire conservatory. But tell me, did you enjoy the performance?
The performance pales in comparison to the lovely lady I saw it with.
You are sidestepping the question.
Love leaves my tongue tied.
Well, in that case, I suppose allowances can be made.
I do hope you recovered from your night at the opera. Any ear-ringing should go away in a day or two. Crossroads. I do not have to tell you to be careful, my love, but... tell me, these strange spaces past the Alluvians, are they safe to explore?
We're taking every precaution we can, Josephine.
I will take your word for it. And yet, you've accomplished so much in the calm of these past years. I wish you did not have to imperil yourself for us. Again.
I won't take unnecessary risks. I have someone far too important to come back to.
And she will be happy for your return. Be safe, my lady. Please. I will do what I can here. Once the Canary are dealt with, brace yourself. The Council is just as relentless. ...of their lyrium. It is not an easy commodity to come by. You've done well. The Exalted Council, meanwhile, has deadlocked.
This is what you do best, Josephine.
I should hope so. But eventually, your hand must be at the wheel. You will be called in soon. Move boldly and swiftly, and you may decide the outcome. The world's eyes are on you, my love. Let us remind them how you Your agents confirm there are Gatlock battles in Denerin's palace?
Yes, and in Valroyo and across the Free Marches. The Winter Palace is not the only target.
The Canary are one order from destroying every noble house in the known world.
There is a bright side. Warning the ambassadors will remind them of the Inquisition's value.
Not when the Inquisition is responsible for that threat.
This is our fault.
Fault? No. But our responsibility.
How did it happen?
The elven servant handling the barrels confessed to working for the Canary.
But the servant was Orlesian. That implicates Orlais, not us.
But the barrels arrived at the Winter Palace on the Inquisition's supply manifest.
How are we supposed to fight a war when we can't even trust our own people?
Do you know who got the barrels onto the Inquisition manifest?
Yes, several of the Inquisition's elven workers have gone missing. I had their backgrounds checked. They joined the Inquisition after fleeing the chaos in Kirkwall.
I remember when Kirkwall was at its worst. Many of the city's elves converted to the Qun, trying to find a better life.
And the Canary turned them into spies.
The Inquisition stopped Corypheus and saved the world. We can't let an outside threat change who we are.
I fought to protect the Inquisition in this Exalted Council. And for what? So we could deceive and threaten those we claimed to protect?
Once we locate the spies...
This isn't about the spies! You hid the Canary body. You've all but seized control of the Winter Palace.
We did what was right, not what was politically convenient.
Do you know what this has cost us with Orlais and Ferelden? They are planning to dismantle us as we speak. And perhaps they are right.
Shit! Damn it! We save Ferelden, and they're angry. We save Orlais, and they're angry. We close the breach twice, and my own hand wants to kill me. Could one thing in this fucking world just stay fixed? I need to get to the Darvarad. You can all fight amongst yourselves once I'm back.
Thank you, Inquisitor.
Would you like us to inform the Exalted Council of the danger?
Yes. If we fail, the Exalted Council needs to know what happened.
I will inform them personally.
Leliana, I can...
No, your job is hard enough already. This is my responsibility.
I'll have guards ready at the Alluvian, in case the Canary attack the palace.
Make a watch over you. agents have found nothing. With the Illuvians, he could be anywhere.
Maintaining the Inquisition, even as a peacekeeping force, leaves us vulnerable to agents of the Dread Wolf.
But also gives us the strength to respond.
We will need to be careful.
Solas knows everything about us. Who we are, how we work, our strengths, and weaknesses.
Then we find people he doesn't know. We will stop Solas by any means necessary.